Hey guys, Bryan Rogala here. This is the 101. Today we are talking ski boots. If you're new to skiing, here's the deal. Boots are the number one most important piece of equipment, hands down. If your boots don't fit right, or you get the wrong type of boot for the skiing that you're gonna be doing, you're not gonna have a good experience. Okay, here's a disclaimer. Buying ski boots is a big investment, and the best way to get the right boot for you is to head to a specialty shop and get professionally fit. A good boot fitter is gonna take a lot of different measurements of your feet, watch how your knees bend, and see how you carry your weight to determine the right ski boot for you. They're also gonna be able to fit those specific boots to your feet through heat molding and custom insoles and all sorts of different things like that that are really important and make a big difference. Okay, now that that's out of the way, let's talk about the different categories of ski boots so you know what to look for when you go into the store. For our purposes, there are three main types of ski boots: alpine, touring, and hybrid. If all you want to do is ride lifts and ski groomed runs or ski in the resort, you need an alpine boot. If you're a backcountry skier or you're going to start skiing fitness laps at your local resort, you need a touring boot. If you fall somewhere in the middle and you want to maybe explore some hike to terrain at the resort, maybe skin a little bit, do a little bit of backcountry skiing, then you may want to look for a hybrid boot that's a combination of the two and works for both types of skiing. Okay, so you're going to a specialty shop, what do you look for? Alpine boots look like this. This is what I ski at the resort. It's a Lang RX 130. It's a traditional four buckle alpine boot, as you can see. No walk mode, a stiff flex rating, and it's got a pretty burly strap up here at the top. This is the kind of boot you want if you're only skiing in the resort, not doing any sort of backcountry skiing. Go for an alpine boot like this. Touring boots are a bit different. This is the Salomon Mountain Explorer. As you can see, it's shorter, it's got a walk mode in the back here, and it's a heck of a lot lighter. And that makes it great for going uphill or on long, flat tours. It's also only got two buckles, so it's nowhere near as stiff and burly as my Lang RX 130 down there. It has tech fittings at the toe and at the heel here, which means it works with a Dynafit style pin binding for touring. It also has grippy rubber soles. As you can see, these look like the soles of a normal hiking boot. And that's great when you're boot packing or scrambling around on rocks and ice. This is the Atomic Backland. As you can see, it's an even more dedicated touring boot than the Salomon Mountain Explorer. I will tell you that this boot does not ski nearly as well as these three boots over here, or even this one. That said, it is the lightest of the bunch, and it's a great touring boot. Now, not all backcountry touring boots are light and flexy and put a premium only on the uphill. Some of them are great hybrids, like the new Technica Zero G Tour Pro. It's got a great walk mode. There's almost 55 degrees of range of motion, and it still has a 130 flex rating, so it's really, really stiff and skis really well. Okay, now for those hybrid boots I mentioned. The first one I'm gonna talk about here is the Lang XT130 LV Free Tour. Whew. Okay, that's a mouthful, but basically, this boot is really similar to this RX 130 that I ski in the resort. So what makes this thing a hybrid boot? But basically, this is a boot that skis like an alpine boot and has a little bit of touring ability built into it. It's also got a walk-to-ride sole, and that means it works fine for some alpine bindings that are compatible, and it also works with AT bindings like a Salomon Guardian or a Dynafit style tech binding. As you can see, it's not as grippy and as great for walking around as this boot is. So if you want one boot to do everything, maybe tour a little bit, explore some hike to terrain and ski the resort, something like the Lang XT Free Tour is a fantastic choice. Just know that there are compromises with a hybrid boot because it's not gonna ski as well as an alpine boot, and it's not gonna tour as well as a backcountry boot. Whew! Okay, that's a lot of info. Here's a recap. If you're new to skiing and looking to buy your own equipment, start with boots. If you're a resort skier only, buy an alpine boot. If you want to get into backcountry skiing or uphill skiing for fitness, buy a touring boot. And if you aren't sure or you want to do a little bit of both, consider a hybrid boot. Whatever you do, make sure you go to a boot fitter and buy the boot that fits you the best and fits your skiing style. Have fun out there.